are what we say, Midwest US states, so there can be students, right? Yeah. Starting with the location, we are a Midwestern US state with coastline. We are very near to Chicago. We are just 150 kilometers away from Chicago. I'm pretty sure you guys must be aware about Wisconsin. Wisconsin itself is a very vibrant state, has many leading industries like mechanical industries, dairy industry, IT. So, Wisconsin and, like, you know, if you it's a Midwestern US state, like the Illinois, you're just above the Illinois, and as I mentioned, very near to Chicago. When you're talking about Milwaukee, it's a large city, it's the largest city of Wisconsin, and it gives the feel of a small town, but, like, you know, the city itself is a, like, we have, like, you know, beautiful lakes, what we say, there are night markets there, and the, like, you know, companies, I mean, so the opportunities are there. We don't have any kind of cut-off scores. Like, so based on your CGPA, your GRE, your like, you know, your other curricular activities, we evaluate overall in your file. Here, anyone interested, apart from engineering, any of the other programs who are interested? Okay, I would also like to share, if you see on the business programs, you will be able to see information technology management. Well, that is ITM, is a STEM program, it's a business program. It's a combination of information technology and management. So again, this is a STEM program. So students who are here, like, with IT, whether you are, like, you know, and who are performers or combination of management, this is an ideal program for them. For this GRE or GMAT, anything, like, any word is accepted. And for business, GMAT is required. Fair? Now, these are the list of STEM programs. So we have STEM programs in architecture, information technology, management science, biomedical science, health science, engineering programs are our STEM programs, economics, mathematics. So these is a few, like, you see, these all are the STEM programs. But I'm not going deep with this, like, each and every program, because here the students are from engineering, and I have already shared the information about engineering.
Your internships and your co-ops, and, you know, having some more experience or maybe do some research projects. So it's in the first year when you have more credits, in the second year you have lesser credits. So students who are looking at any of the master's course programs, these are the different concentrations. Typically these concentrations, you take it right from the first semester onwards. It is the program coordinators who help you to identify the different coursework that you need to do, and accordingly you are to register for it. The course fees for UMass Lowell is $47,000 for the coming year, which is about roughly 34 lakhs Indian currency for 2 years. We do have scholarships up to $8,000. And of course, like I said, through co-ops, you can earn literally almost half of your tuition fees by doing any of the engineering course program at UMass Lowell. So that is all I would like to wrap up. We come again for the fourth year. I know you're in the third year, don't want to download you too much of things. My only request to you is that maintain your grades. So the admission criteria for most of the universities will be a GRE score of 300. We look more of your form score. We do look at your verbal score. So it could depend university to university, but on a majority, we look at your form score. So anything above 150 is a decent score. But anything less than a 150 quants is low. So try to target for higher quantitative scores in your GRE, 300 plus